So today we are gonna make some delicious salted caramel coconut pralines. And these are so, so delicious. And oh my gosh, you really need to try them. They are awesome. I will show you how I'm gonna do this, and I've done this a couple of times and it's just so good. I really really love it, and the people I shared it with also really really loved it. For this we are gonna use 300 grams of coconut shreds, and these are just simple dried organic white coconut shreds. You don't have to use organic if you don't have that. And also I'm gonna use 10 small pitted dates and 1.5 tablespoon of raw cacao powder. You could use regular cacao powder if you don't have the raw version. And I'm gonna use 1.5 tablespoon to 2 tablespoons of carob powder, a big pinch of pink Himalayan sea salt, and a big pinch of bourbon vanilla powder. So that's what I'm going to use. And depending on your blender, you may need a little bit of coconut oil or just a little bit of cacao butter to get it very well running. And the first thing we are going to do is just make the coconut butter. And I want to make a bigger batch and it doesn't fit into one cup, so I'm gonna use 2 cups for this. So I'm gonna do it in 2 times. Each cup does contain 150 grams of coconut shreds, and we are just going to make this into a butter. So, and for this I'm just using my grinding blade. I have a little coffee grinder like a blender, because I found that works the best for me. You could also use a high-speed blender or any other kind of blender you can use for making nut butters. And then we have here already one portion of the coconut butter. I'm just going to scrape this down. Then we are going to make our other portion. Same for this one. We're just going to scrape it down. It's already a nice coconut butter. If it doesn't get runny enough or smooth enough, you could use some cacao butter or coconut oil. And cacao butter does also really taste delicious in this. I will try it without. Or maybe I will add a little bit of coconut butter, but I think I will try it without because it does look very nice and runny. So, and now I think I will try to add in the dates in one cup and the other powdered dry ingredients into the other one. And then at the end mixing it all together. So that's what I'm going to do. And then just blend it again. You can of course use more or less dates, or leave them out also. Would work. It's just whatever you prefer. I like it now with the dates, but you don't have to do so. So that's one. And in the other cup I will blend and powdered ingredients in. It does also get warm because of the mixing process, so therefore it will also get runnier. And this is really really nice and runny, as you can see. Oh my gosh, really, it does look like chocolate, like liquids melting chocolate. Wow. Now we are going to mix all together, or at least we try to do so. I just need to try this. Oh my goodness. Yes, this is without a date and it does really really taste good. So, oh my gosh, yeah, you can definitely leave out the dates if you want. Just, it is just maybe a little bit less sweet, but really really delicious still. So I just try to incorporate it already a little bit, and then we will close it off again and blend it one more time. Looks very very good. I think it will be very very good. And then I will use some little ice cube trays, and then we are going to add it in here and put it into the fridge to harden up. Maybe you could even add a little bit more of the cacao or the carob powder. That would also be great, but this is also already really delicious. So I will keep it like this. If you like the flavor a little bit stronger, just add in a little bit more of the cacao and the carrot powder, maybe a little pinch more of salt. But I think this is really, really good already. And to make it even more low carb, you could also, of course, instead of the dates, use some sweetener, something like stevia or erythrit, so xylitol, something like that. And that would also be possible. Or just leave the dates out because the coconut's also sweet, so it would also be still taste really good. Dates do have a little bit of a caramelly taste, so therefore it does really work very well for this. Our palinés or bonbons are ready, and they did just harden up in the fridge. And you can just store them in the fridge in a container, and there they will last a really long time. Oh.